Today, one person with the side hustle is going to win $10,000. We had over 350 applications, and we picked the top four to pitch me. Now, these are full-time employees or students who want to turn their side hustles into their main hustle. And if they win today, that might become a reality for them.
You have 5 minutes to pitch. I just want you to take the money and then invest as much of it as possible into your business. Let's get it on.
Boom. I'm Colby. This is my partner, Yair. He's so good-looking, he doesn't even need any taglines. We started a company called Stonehaven Home Improvement. Why Stonehaven? Because that's the name of our neighborhood. My wife went and I went to New York. I came back a week early. She was really pregnant. So me and Yair got together, made a baby room. One way we sell products, instead of saying, let us paint your room, we say, here's a baby room special. Comes with popcorn ceiling removal, painting, new carpet, whole thing. So how do we do it? We just said yes to anything the customer asked, figured out how to do it later. What do we do? Wash, rinse, and repeat, baby. We're just getting used to this whole taking pictures before and after, but for the longest time, we had really just tried to perfect our craft, and now we're trying to market that craft. So here's a little shot of the garage, some before and after cabinet pictures that we painted, a shed that was really bad that we made really good. And how are we getting these customers? Word of mouth, posting on Nextdoor, posting on your Facebook neighborhood groups, and we also spend money on Thumbtack and Facebook. Yep. So here's our sales. So since July, not including this month. Since July, $139,615.71 in revenue, and our gross profit's been about $50,000.
This month is gonna be 110K in 1 month.
So what's our plan to invest the 10K?
What are we gonna do with this money? Okay.
We can make it rain. What else can we do with the 10K? We know there's a lot of products that we can create and take to market. Like for example, we're working on something right now to gather rainwater below your gutters and people can flush their toilets with rainwater. Why you gotta pay the government to like flush your toilet? It's free.
Yo, can you guys hire me? You guys are making more money than I make. Why not just double down on the home improvement stuff and really make that a multi-million dollar business before you start even getting, I'm worried that you're getting distracted with like new shiny shit when it's like, this one thing is working really well. Plus you could do like the comedy shtick. You know, you go there, hello, it's me, it's him.
When I got Squatty Potty, I was like, I mean, I'm pretty handy.
You'll be before the squatty and you'll be after the squatty.
Oh my gosh. I was like, this is the most incredible product because I actually could hook this up to my own plumbing. I felt so empowered. Yeah. Why? The directions, everything was so amazing in it. If I could create the same aftermarket product to go in the house, whether rainwater harvesting to, you know, more insulation in the house to really patch some holes, things like that.
Do you guys do all the work or do you find people?
We do some.
We do some of the work, yeah.
That's it.
All right, gentlemen. Go. I love it. I'm going to do the clapping thing. Nice job, guys.
If bananas were green, they could change the world. Let me explain. Now, I don't drink, so to drown my sorrows, I exchange my scotch for my favorite snack that my Ghanaian relatives send, and that is plantain chips. These chips are the best-kept secret of the tropical regions. They're a widely known delicacy, but in my country, there wasn't a single place to get them from. And with that, Plantinos was born. The first Central European brand of authentically African premium plantain snacks.
How long has all this taken you?
I've been working on this idea for around 8 months.
Nice.
I niched down to a segment with the most restricted diet and a hair on fire problem, which was the paleo and autoimmune community, and they became my beachhead market. After traveling to Ghana myself and meeting with all the people involved in making Plantinos, I saw the immense potential of good food also having good impact. And I decided to start donating an additional 10% to initiatives supporting African agritech innovation.
So first off, awesome presentation, man. What's your dream with this business?
To create something like Oatly or Tom's Shoes in the snack space. Good food that does good for the world, honestly.
Aloha everyone, my name is Amanda Punani Cordes. I'm the owner of the Seafood Cartel here in Honolulu, Hawaii. I'm half Hawaiian, half Mexican. The idea behind the Seafood Cartel was really simple. My family's potluck dish is always ceviche, and every time we bring ceviche, everyone is always super stoked. So I always thought to myself, like, why is everyone so excited for ceviche? And then I realized it's because nowhere here in Hawaii can you find fresh, authentic Mexican seafood. Thus, the Seafood Cartel was born. My first sale date was September 19th, 2020, and we started with only two products, our 32-ounce shrimp ceviche and our crab spread. People could only order through Instagram, and pickups were only on Saturdays from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. 7 months later, we started doing the farmers market. So we do farmers markets on Saturday and Sunday, And this has been huge for our business. So our main marketing channel is Instagram. That is how people pre-order, and that is how I post my menu, my specials, or any other important information. So I normally spend on the high end $15 a week to give free products to local influencers who, in exchange, post my signature on their page. So from January 2021 to now, I've had $162,000 in sales. My highest earning month was September of 2021 at $16,000. And my average monthly sales is $15,000. I need your $10,000 because as of now, I do not have the space to increase production. I'm pretty much at my max capacity of how much ceviche I can put. In the space I'm in right now, I cannot have any more inventory than I actually do. And I cannot hire any more staff.
Dude, mahalo. Wow. That was not what I expected. Most importantly, all right, so if we give you $10,000, can we get ceviche for life? Like when we come visit, maybe like once a week?
Yes. Easy.
One thing I was curious, do you have a budget for next year?
Before December, my main goal is to make 5,000, by just doing farmers markets, it's 5,000 a week. And then if I get into a store space, I think I could do double that, at least $10,000 a week.
Keep going regardless, just amazing the progress you've already made.
Yo, I'm Jesse, this is Skill Fuel. Our aim is to help people feel better, do more.
My name is Robert, I'm the owner of Revamp Marketing, successful agency that's worked with Rich Brony and some other clientele in that stature.
Yeah, so what is Skill Fuel? It's coffee creamer with supplements. Our first product is a coffee creamer with nootropics, mushrooms, and collagen that gives you longer lasting energy and focus than the coffee it's in. I found the ingredients, came up with the formula, reached out to manufacturers, found one that fit my needs. I called up Robert, he's my brother-in-law. I knew he was the guy I needed. He's a marketing guru and didn't take much convincing. He said, I'm all in, baby. So we did a soft launch on Facebook. We had like 50 pre-orders.
You know, we'll get some low-hanging fruit with some Google Shopping, branded search ads. To acquire the new customers, really focusing on TikTok, Facebook, and Pinterest. We're currently not promoting just to get the order in first.
I guess one thing I'm still not clear on is how does it taste? And why haven't you guys done more in-person tastings? Like, you did it, and then you're kind of like, well, we're waiting. Like, you guys could have all these tastings and things going on in the interim.
Why we chose our manufacturers, because they acquired a tasting company that was filled with tasting engineers. And so their whole value proposition is we are the best powder manufacturer to make this product taste how you want. I trust them more than I trust me when it comes to that type of stuff.
And then when do you guys get the product, you think?
3 to 4 months.
Dude, you can't make some creamer shit? Like Jeremy, who's the producer of the show, is his former boss was Tom Bilyeu from Quest Bars. And they were baking bars at home.
I mean, we did that, but it's like packaging and all that. I mean, what are we gonna do? Put it in a little Ziploc bag? And
yeah, yeah. Go and actually get more, you know, validation, and instead of waiting like 3 months to like, you know, see how things turn out. I'm gonna go sync up with Jeremy, and we're about to announce the $10,000 side hustle winner.
So, I mean, it's hard, man.
Dude, this is super hard. I really thought like the first one, I was like, oh, that's great, and then that's great. Let's go through them. Colby Foster, those guys were just hysterical, man. I just wanted to keep hearing them talk. I don't think they really needed the money. Like, they would have put up photos of, like, their Costco membership. Oliver.
I love the attitude, and, I think he can really benefit from the money as well. He would put this money to good use.
Amanda, we loved.
She's pulling in some big numbers. I think she really can benefit from the money. It seems like she's one of the participants that can benefit from it the most.
Strong. She's making a lot of money. It's in her family. I love that she's taking advantage of like her interest in her culture. I love, honestly, Mexican and ceviche. It's just like, it's a weakness. It's like kryptonite to me. Jesse Haywood, the Skill Fuel. I really like those guys. I think the downside for me is that they're waiting around, and I really would have liked to see them had the coffee tested and tasted sooner.
You wanna hop back in and kind of announce the winner?
Let's do it. What up? If you're an entrepreneur or you've always wanted to be one, you do not want to miss out on AppSumo.com, our company's Black Friday special. This is 1 week of the year with insane discounts on the best software tools online. This is November 21st through November 30th. Make sure you check it out at AppSumo.com, and we have a link below in the description. See you there. I want to give all of you guys $10,000 or more. You have full-time jobs. Some of you have families and kids, significant others. Even the college students, you guys, I guess you aren't really that busy, but the fact that you guys made these things happen, it's so easy to just kind of watch it. It's so hard to be about it and do it. Are you guys ready for the announcement of the winner? The winner of the first ever and not last Side Hustler giveaway, $10,000, is Oliver.
Oh my my God! No! No!
What are you gonna do with the money? Talk about the $10,000.
I can call the logistics company and tell them start preparing a nice big 20-footer container for me so we can get these plantains going.
If this video inspired you to start your own side hustle, make sure to check out this video right up here where I show you how to start a side hustle business even if you have a full-time job. And make sure to subscribe to the channel if you're not already. Uncle Noah loves you, wants to make sure he sends you all his videos. I love you, and I'll see you out there. Pew pew.